I was hoping that we could start by taking a group photo together. So I'm going to hold up this kind of special camera, and even you guys too. If you just wave and smile when I say 3, 2, 1, together. Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay. Are we ready? 3, 2, 1, woohoo! That's going to be fun. I'm sure. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
We've been hearing from a lot of different countries and a lot of different locales, and especially related to food and community. But for this presentation, I'd like to just slightly switch gears a little bit and kind of talk about our digital society and how this is affecting the way that we're sharing information, especially when in regards to getting information to know where to travel, where to eat, and after the fact, or maybe where we're out traveling somewhere, we have these sort of like to call them guided explorers, right? They're not really exploring by day, they're holding their phone out and kind of around to certain places. How are they getting their information? How is it guiding them to tourism? Right? And also, we just heard a little bit about CBT, community-based tourism. And we also have an online community that we're involved with, right? We have our local groups and our families and our communities, but we also are connected to each other, not by boundary or by family, but also by common interests or maybe a common experience or places. These are becoming increasingly more important, especially for marketing purposes, for travel, for liberation of information, for travel purposes. So I'm going to talk about this particular topic today. I don't know if anyone's heard of this before. Has anyone heard of eWOM? eWOM, anybody? A couple of people, right? Sometimes people would maybe call it social media marketing or some other simplified name. But everyone knows email, right? Electronic mail, right? We used to have send letters. We don't know how many of you used to do that. Then we have email, which is even kind of got old numbers and text dashes. But the same thing applies here. WOM is word of mouth. And now we are kind of sharing our information through the internet, either before we travel, trying to look for information. When we travel, trying to find people who are in the same place or gather the same place to get guided information to the language that we refer to information in. So the official definition, I'm going to read real quickly here, just to kind of prove a point later on. eWOM is any positive or negative statement made by potential, actual, or former customer, which is available to a multitude of people via the internet. And that is kind of a well accepted definition of it in research, but it's just so broad, it's almost unusable. It's basically any kind of find information or share information on the internet for commercial purposes, primarily for commercial purposes. So I'm going to try to kind of conceptualize this concept for us, give us some examples of how it's being used, and kind of come down on some of the ways we can start to use this idea for our own promotion of our own tourism destination or restaurants. This is a picture of a famous ramen noodle store in Fukushima, in the northern part of Kyoto Prefecture, where I lived for some years. This is the most famous noodle stand in the city. And like we heard a couple other places today, people will travel from the city, which is about 90 minutes from Kyoto, about 90 minutes also from Osaka, just to come eat some ramen noodles at the shop. People are lined up almost every day. You line up until the soup comes out, and then they put a sign on the door. So you walk by this and you see that this must be popular. This is almost like a kind of word of mouth as it's now. As you walk by it, you know it's good. Something's good inside just by the sheer number of people meeting outside. But how do people discover this? How do people share this? And how do people know where this run out? It's all kind of linked to information that's being sent out on the internet. So as this looks to a person walking down the street, a person trying to find information on the internet might find something like this. This is in Japanese, but this is a popular review website for restaurants in Japan called Tabeo. And this is the restaurant's official ranking and the reviews that have been placed for this particular restaurant. It has a 5-star rating, and this particular restaurant has a 3.56, which, if you first look at it, you might think it's low, but this is the highest rated ramen restaurant in all of Kyoto Prefecture. There are a lot of ramen restaurants. This is a very interesting phenomenon in itself that is very unheard of to see or give a 5-star rating to a ramen restaurant anywhere. Because it's such a well-known food, people are very finicky and have their own personal taste so much that 3.5 is the highest ranking in all of Kyoto Prefecture. So you can see that the 70 people have already given reviews is a lot. And that's just like what we see before waiting outside at the end. People are talking about this. This is generating content on the internet. And this is really what the name of the game is in this field. It's having people, everyone, all people on the internet, take that information and make it their own, and add their own spice, their own flavor, their own opinion, and share it with the people around. So you can see this media mind is related to this in the digital. So this study of eWOM, electronic word of mouth, is trying to understand how people are sharing this information and how it influences their behaviors, especially when it concerns your child. So let's get a little background here. Has anyone ever seen this image? It's kind of cool, but faded. What do you think that looks like? Fireworks? Yeah. Constellation looks like stars. This is a visual representation of the internet, right? So when we started out in the early 60s, we opened in just 4 locations in the United States connected by the internet. Now we have billions and billions of internet things connected, devices connected, networks connected, other networks on the internet. And this has become a vast, very complicated, very big. To me, what I think about it is very awe-inspiring, how vast and complicated we take for granted this telecommunication system that we have. And this kind of is an analogy to how our communications is spread from person to person. Because this represents connections between devices and computers on the internet, but we also have personal connections that might look a lot like this. So we have a technological level of connected devices, or how fast is the internet connection between devices and platforms that we all share together. But we also have personal connections that are social and emotional that are on top of it. So it becomes a little bit complicated in trying to quantify how information is being passed from one point to another. And when you start to dig into some research, you see a lot of